हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर ज्योति गंगुडे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, केटीएचएम कॉलेज नासिक। स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द फिशरी बाय प्रोडक्ट्स। नाउ सो देयर आर सो मेनी फिशरी बाय प्रोडक्ट्स सच एज द फिश मील, देन फिश फ्लोर, देन फिश लिवर ऑयल, आइसिंग ग्लास, फिश ग्लू, फिश मैन्यूर, फिश गोआनो or either fish fin soup. Okay, these are the different derivatives or byproducts of fishery or fishing industry. Now we can see all these products or discuss all these products one by one. Okay, now here before that we are just introducing regarding the fishery byproduct. Okay, now the fishes that are consumable for human consumption and discarded the part of fin as a gut, gills, fins, okay, and it may be proceed into edible meal and oils that are obtained as byproducts of fish industries. Now several products they are obtained from the waste of fisheries. They include the fish meal which is used for animal feeding and as a manure. Now the fish flour for human consumption, then leather and the glue which form the fish skin, then imitation pearl or either foam producing compounds or either active carbon forms such as the scales, then icing glass, then adhesives, okay, from air bladders of fishes, okay, from insulin which is derived from the pancreas of fishes, either from the sex hormones, from the gonads of fishes, again proteamines from the milk, histamines from the flesh, and guanine and cytosine from the scales of fishes. Now the details of various fish byproducts and their uses, they are giving or I mentioned such a products one by one here. Now the first one is the fish meal. Now the fish meal, it is the dried fish powder which is formed from oil and it has been extracted. Okay, now it is a residual cake after oil extraction. Now the fish meal, which is a nutritious feed supplement mainly or which contains proteins, minerals as well as vitamins. Now if we can discuss regarding its raw material, the raw material which include the fish meal which is produced from the raw material such as the mackerels, then sharks or either rays, either robin fish or either silver belly fish. Okay, now after that we will discuss in short the process of preparation of such a kind of fish meal. Now the trash fishes like Leognathus, then laser sardines and anchovies and fish waste are commonly used for the production of fish meal through weight reduction process. The basic principle involved is that the source material are ground and boiled in sufficient quantity of water in large pots. The result is that the coagulation of protein occurs and it is followed by release of water and oil. Now the water and oil are secreted and the liquid protein, which is known as a press liquor, is passed through a screen mode of canvas or coil bags in screen places to remove water and separate the solid particles of fish. Now later these particles are returned to press cake. After drying the press cake in the sun, it is ground well and then packed in polythene lined film bags. Now in dry process, the raw material is exposed in high temperature or more commonly in steam jackal drums or often under the partial vacuum. Now the vacuum drying process gives a superior product. The solid mass obtained is packed and marked. Now the fish meal can be stored in airtight sterilized containers for a fairly long period. Now, if we can discuss regarding its composition, it includes protein, which is near about 65%, moisture, fat, and ash contents vary at 6 to 10%, either 5 to 10%, and more exceeds near about 12 to 33%. Now, again, all essentials and non-essentials amino acids, okay, they are also the composition of such a fish meal. Whereas minerals such as calcium, phosphorus, copper, zinc, manganese, iodine and selenium, they are also content of fish meal. Now, if it's used, so the fish meal is formed a very valuable food for poultry and cattle. Due to its high protein and vitamin contents, it increases milk and egg production. It is demanded by fish feed manufacturers as well as for the reason of its very rich nutritive balance. The next is fish flour. Now, the fish flour, or which is also known as a hydrolyzed protein. Now, such a hydrolyzed protein or fish flour, which is a very superior quality of fish meal, which is used for human consumption. Now, its raw material include the part of fish which is left after oil extraction in fishes such as the mackerels, then salmon, oil sardine, or either shark or either ray fish. Okay. Now, if you can discuss regarding this process, now it is prepared on a commercial scale mostly by the application of solvent extraction process. The fish flour prepared therefore forms an ideal protein supplement to human diet. Okay, it is a supplementary human diet. Now, it is produced in India, South Africa as well as in USA. Now, its composition include, it is a whole source of protein. Okay, now, or its use. Now, it can be used in several forms, but the best use is its blending with wheat or maize flour. Now, it is also added in small quantities for enriching the nutritive values of bread, biscuits, cakes, sweets, soap, or either gravy. Now, it has been found that mixing of fish flour at a level up to 10% dose not alter the taste and the overall appearance of bread, which is rather better. Now, it is a favored item in Africa and Southeast Asian countries. Now, this is what regarding the fish flour. Now, next is the fish liver oil. Now, the oil which is produced from liver of fishes like cod, tuna, then halibut, and some of the sharks, such a oil, okay, which is derived, and such a oil which is called as a fish liver oil. Now, the raw material which include in India, fish liver oil is extracted from the livers of sharks and rays such as a spirna, pristis, coleodon, as well as trigon. Now, the fishes used here. Now, there are three classes of fish livers of commercial values they are recognized. Now, the fish liver with high oil content and low vitamin A potency. Okay, now it includes cods whose liver yields 60 to 75% oil with 500 to 20,000 IU per gram of vitamins. Now, the second one, that is fish liver with low oil content and high vitamin A potency, which include the fishes such as the tuna, now whose liver yields near about 4 to 28% of the liver. Now, after that, the fish liver with high oil content, such as the fishes includes the hammer-headed shark, okay, where the liver of such a fish which yields near about 25 to 75% of oil content. Now, we'll discuss regarding its composition. Now, The fish liver oils contain several valuable items including 55 to 75% of fat, 5 to 10% of protein, water and vitamin A and vitamin D. Now the two important vitamins such as the vitamin A and D are essential for man and are present in liver oil in a required quantity. As such, a medicinal value of fish liver oil is enormous. Now, its process. Now, the various firms use various methods for extracting the liver oil. Now, we have some kind of common methods, okay, by which we can derive the such a kind of liver oil. Now, the first method is the boiling. Boiling method, which include liver is chopped into small processes or pieces and boiled with sufficient water. Then the oil is skimmed off from the surface of water. Now this is the simplest and cheapest method of extraction of oil from the liver. Okay, now we can do it at a very primary level also. Now then the there is use of two metallic receptacles with 2 to 3 inches of space between them. Now here the liver pieces are placed in inner chamber and the water in the space between the two receptacles. Now the water is heated to boiling point on a fire. Now in this duration liver is constantly stirred to avoid oxidation. That means what in general in boiling process what we have to do? We have to make the pieces, okay, chop the fish, okay, or make the pieces, and after washing it, okay, we have to boil the pieces with addition of water, and at a time is come, a level is come where the oil which is released from the tissues of fishes and which float on the surface of water. Okay, this is the very primary or first level of the fish oil which is derived from the fishes. Okay, the second method which is the steaming method. Now, the liver pieces are heated by steam under the pressure using steam kettle with automatic safety valve to control the pressure. Now, in the kettle which is fitted a steering mechanism operated the steam. Okay, the modern oil extraction plant which represent the adaptation of recently developed technology. Liver is sent in the form of cutaneous steam to a cooker which is proved with a rotating steam element for heating. Now the temperature which is gradually rise to 90 to 97 degree and the liver is allowed to pass though on shaking sieves to a settling tank. Now the oil is drained through a pipe and liver residues then delivered to a centrifuge for further processing. Now this is what by means of the simply the steaming method, okay, we can derive the fish liver oil. Now the third method is the solvent extraction method. The solvent extraction method here, the liver pieces are first crushed to pulp and dehydrated with salt like sodium sulfate to remove the moisture. Now, the dehydrated mass is extracted from an organic solvent like ethylene trichloride oil, which is obtained by distilling solvent like ethylene chloride oil, which is obtained by distilling the solvent. Now, as it is costly process, which is less preferred. Now, the next method is the alkali method. Now, the liver pieces are first allowed to be digested in weak alkali solution by heating. Now, the hot liquid is then centrifuged to release the oil. Okay, now this is what regarding the four methods of extraction of fish liver oil. The first one is the boiling, followed by steaming. Third one is the solvent extraction, and the last one is the alkali method. Okay, so here its use is, now as the oil has great medicinal value, particularly in curing both, that is rickets and xerophthalmia, it has a great demand in the country. Now the next product is the isinglass. Now isinglass, meaning isinglass, is a pure gelatinous substance which is obtained from the inner lining of the swine bladder, or what we say that the swimming bladder, okay, or it has also called as the inner bladder. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to obtain the gelatinous substance from the swimming bladder or either air bladder of the fishes. Okay, and now the fishes, which includes catfish, then carps, eel, then polynemids, sea bass. Okay, so we have different category of fishes. Okay, by from their air bladder we can extract the substance, that is isinglass. Now such a isinglass has a high grade which is a high grade of collagen product. Okay, now the raw material which include air bladder of marine as well as freshwater fish like the cuttlefish, carp and either flat fishes. Now the process such as the isinglass is made in various parts of the world from the swim bladder of sounds, as they are known to the trade of such a diverse fishes such as the carps, catfishes, then cod fishes, a hake fishes, drums, okay, or either thread fish. Okay, now from the fish selected, the bladders, okay, such a bladders they first remove, and the blood and adhering materials are scraped off. Okay, what we have to do, we have to first isolate the air bladder from those fishes. Okay, and whatever the material which is adhering, okay, we have to scrape such a material, okay, scrape out or scrape off such a kind of excess of the material. Now after that, they are cut open and washed thoroughly in running water. Following this, the outer black membrane is removed by scraping and the bladders are cut into pieces. Now the pieces are dried in an artificial dryer or either in open sky, means giving the exposure of sunlight. Now after all this processing, the product which is stored in suitable containers. Now the use such as, there are many uses of this product. The most common use is in the clarifying beverages like the beer, wine, either in vinegar, okay, for making either jellies, okay, now, or either preparation of certain cementing substances. Now isinglass also effective in the reduction of suspended solids in beer and increase the rate of filtration for that is near about 3000 to 11000 liters. Now the other use of this product are as an adhesive base in the confectionery products, then Indian ink work manufacture, and also as an efficient adhesive for glass, then pottery and leather products manufactures. Now isinglass products having moisture content less than 8% and find the preference for industrial purpose. Okay, now this is what regarding the isinglass. The next byproduct is the fish glue. Now fish glue is a product obtained mainly from fishes such as the cod, then haddock, pollack and hake. Now the raw material which include the skin, fin, bones and body parts of fishes. Now the procedure which include, most of the fish glue which is derived from the skin of the fish, but waste glue and fish head glue are also manufactured. Now the usage which include, the fish glue is considered a good adhesive and is used for smearing the backs of load stamps and labels. Now the glue obtained from cord which is of superior quality and finds the use in photo engraving. After that, when the product is of low quality, which is utilized as adhesive for paper boxes, shoes and other things such as a furniture, where joining is required. Now in USA, it is known for producing the larger amount of fish glue. Okay, now after that, the fish manure. Now fish manure here, which is such a fish manure is the inferior quality of fish meal, which is unfit as animal feed. Now, such a fish manure, which is not suitable for a human food, but it is using as a manure. Now, it includes or its compositions such as, it contains 5-7% of nitrogen, 4-6% of the phosphorus and 4-6% of calcium oxalate. Now, the fish which are generally used for preparation of fish manure are sand horse mackerels, then sardines and other few species of the fishes. Now they are available in abundance in the coastal fishing areas. Now process include, the preparation of fish manure is simply by prepared by drying the fish in sun on the sea beach. Now the supply of fish is maintained in two ways. When there is abundant supply of fish and surplus are left after the sale, and they are used in sun drying. Now also when the fish are brought to the shore in spoiled condition and they are found unfit for human consumption, now they find utility in the form of dry fish. The fish are simply spread on the beach and dried. This dried fish on mixing with ash forms an ideal kind of manure. Now the product being already cooked during the processing for oil extraction decomposes quickly in the soil and mixes well. Now the use which include, it has a high nutritive value, are generally three kinds of manures they are obtained from such a fishes, like the fish manure, then prawn manure and fish guano. Now it is used largely as a manure in plantation of coffee, tea as well as tobacco. Now after that, the next product is the fish guano. Fish guano, it is also known as a fish ghee. So it is a separate kind of fish fertilizer. It is prepared from oil, sardine or cooked and pressed for body oil in fish oil industry. The solid matter left from the fish guano having 8-10% of nitrogen and 5-7% of phosphate. It has high nutritional value and it is absorbed easily by the bone. Now it is a fish cake left after the extraction of oil. Now the guano is produced as a byproduct of the oil extracting fishes. Now it is rich in protein and nitrogen contents along with the phosphorus and calcium. Now its uses which include, it has high nutritive value. It is used largely as a manure in the plantation of coffee, tea as well as in tobacco. Now the next byproduct is the fish fin soup. Now the shark fins are used for making soup. Now there are two main grades of a shark fins. One which is a fine one and obtained from the small shark, and the other which is the coarse and which is obtained or which is prepared by big sized of sharks. Now they are first soaked in plain water or softened in water which is acidified with vinegar with pH ranging from 2.5 to 5 for near about 2 to 3 days. Now freshly cut fins, they require less soaking time. The softened fins are then treated with 10% acetic acid at 60% for about 1 hour. Now the translucent cartilaginous rods which remain embedded in the fins of shark and become visible. Now after removing the skin, the extraneous muscle, cartilage bones, or fins, they are boiled till the fin rays get separated from the remaining cartilage bones and muscles. Now the rays are separated manually, washed well, then soaked in cold water containing small quantity of hydrogen peroxide for 2 hours and then washed. Now the fin product can be used immediately for the preparation of shark fin soup. Now the softened clean fin rays after separation of extraneous material can be washed well and dried in sun. The dried rays, which usually contain moisture near about 5 to 8% and which can be stored in polythene bags, market in foreign countries like in China, Philippines, Hong Kong, or either in Singapore or either various parts of the world. Now fish fin soup is favored by Chinese and which costs near about $110 in Hong Kong restaurant. Okay, now this is what regarding the fish fin soup, or this is all whatever all about the fishery byproducts. Okay, in next lecture we'll discuss regarding the fish preservation techniques.